Now, this week, I wanted to really dive in and focus on, for the reintroduction period, how can we break this down so that it's very, very clear what is being reintroduced when, what the options are, and what a typical day on a reintroduction day would look like, okay? So first, to briefly recap, and I'll just keep moving my face around, to briefly recap, the fast track reintroduction option is one of the two choices that the Whole30 franchise puts out there. Fast track, slow roll. For the fast track, you are taking 15 days, usually, and you are reintroducing a food, then going back to a strict Whole30 for 2 days, reintroducing a food, going back to the strict Whole30 for 2 days, until you've reintroduced the groups of food that you want to trial in this manner and see how they feel in your body. Okay. And I'm specifically guiding us through this sequence. So gluten-free alcohol, then legumes, then non-gluten grains, then dairy, then gluten-containing grains, and then we'll be done with the group-supported structure. Of course, if you want to keep doing this on your own, you absolutely can. And that's part of why I want to dive into this, so that you feel empowered to do that. The slow roll reintroduction does not follow a particular timeline at all. It is completely up to you. So this is for the folks who are thinking to themselves, I could keep doing this diet forever. It's totally fine. I like it better than the way before. For those folks, you can continue doing this on your own timeline when there's something that suddenly looks inviting, whether it's chocolate or bread or a special dinner cooked by friends, outdoor distanced in a social gathering, whatever it is, then you try something and you indulge, and then you see how you feel. And so very different pros and cons with the slow roll, but that's just another option to put out there. So again, the point of the reintroduction period is to reintroduce, wait 2 days, and then reintroduce again. And the reason for that is we're aiming to see what the ripple effect is from the foods that you add back in, right? So if you have dairy and then you have GI upset, the GI upset is like the ripples in water when you throw a stone or you watch, you know, a water bug walk on the surface. The GI upset, those are the ripples that tell you that your body doesn't tolerate dairy super well. And then you wait until you don't have any upset. So for instance, if I reintroduce dairy and on days 2 and 3, I'm having GI upset, then I would want to wait before reintroducing bread or non-gluten grains. Right? Want to wait until my GI is back to normal and then reintroduce the next foods. So keep an eye out for if you do have a reaction in some way, and I'm not talking about allergic reaction, because again, we're not reintroducing allergens. We're reintroducing the foods that you don't believe you have an allergic reaction to, and then seeing if your body tolerates them well. So now I want to just dive in and say, okay, when we talk about legumes, this is what we mean. And then this is an example day of what, when we reintroduce legumes, you could do. So the beans, black beans, pinto, garbanzos, et cetera, peanuts, soy. However, we're not talking about chocolate peanut butter, you know, dip from the store, or a black bean burger that has 20 other ingredients, including oats and soy and some sort of, you know, isolated soy protein. You want to try and keep these reintroductions as straightforward and whole foods based as possible, so that you can really see if it's the food itself that might be bugging you, or if it's the additives that are incorporated into these food products that bother you. I hope that makes sense. So for example, legume reintroduction day, peanut butter on apples with breakfast, chickpeas and salad with lunch, lentil soup for dinner. You're just kind of adding things back in from this category. If you have a reaction, you can then decide, since my gut was upset, or since I didn't sleep well, or my mood was off, do I want to do a further reintroduction just in this category to say, let me just do chickpeas for a day and then do the Whole30 for 2 days and then see what happens. That's up to you. Non-gluten grains, corn, oatmeal, white or brown rice, quinoa. Okay. So that could be a tortilla with lunch. That could be oatmeal with breakfast. That could be rice with dinner, you know, anything kind of like that, where you're doing a little bit of everything throughout the day within this category, going back to the Whole30 for 2 days. Dairy, we're looking at heavy cream, full fat milk, butter, yogurt, cheese. Now, what we don't want to do is have bread and cheese on the same day. So that picture on the bottom right that has the lovely baguette right next to, I guess that's brie. I'm not the best with cheese. But we wouldn't want to do that because then you don't know which thing feels what way in your body. So we're just doing cheese by itself, or yogurt by itself, or butter by itself. Cream in the coffee, cheese with your salad at lunch, butter sauce over chicken at dinner. Whatever you want within this category and keeping it straightforward and simple. So not the yogurt that has a lot of additives where there's sugar, but then there's also like 10 more ingredients. You would want to just do plain yogurt. Gluten-containing grains, whole grain, bread, wraps, tortillas, pasta, couscous, crackers, low-sugar, whole grain cereals, beer, right? But again, you want to try and keep it kind of simple, because if you reintroduce gluten-containing grains by doing some very sugary cereal, it's not going to be clear if it's something else in the cereal or if it's the gluten that's bugging you, right? Whereas if it's just the bread and it's just a whole grain bread with not really anything else in it, it will be clear if your body does not like that. So example, toast with breakfast, tortilla wrap with lunch, pasta with dinner. I'm putting this slide in here because I will send this PowerPoint out as a PDF, and I think it's a useful one to have as a reference. This goes through each of the Whole30 kind of reintroduction categories. Note that the added sugar and the gluten-free alcohol are optional, okay? And it gives you kind of, okay, so for legumes, these are the kinds of things we're talking about with some examples. For non-gluten grains, same thing. And I incorporated a little bit of this in my presentation, but this kind of gives it all to you in one picture. And so I thought that would be a useful tool to have. Now, I just want to remind everyone that changing habits, especially changing food habits, is work, and it's hard and uncomfortable at times. And we're still in the process here of evaluating what feels good and what doesn't. And that's kind of a new approach to food. And so I just want you to kind of pause and offer yourself some self-compassion at some point today or this week, and just notice and get kind of curious, like, what has this process been like for you? And what are you learning? Like, what are the fruits? What's the flower in this process for you? That's the insight and the takeaway you can carry forward. And what becomes possible for you and your health by having done this process, right? And that's it for today's presentation. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to let me know how you're doing. And if you have questions or updates about what this experience is like for you, I'm here to support you along the way. We've got 2 more weeks of structured support, so keep that in mind.